Hello filmmakers and welcome to Storesium. In this video I'm bringing an old tutorial of mine back to life. We're going to turn a simple clip of opening a door into an interesting video transition. Let's not waste any time and jump over to Premiere to start some editing. Inside Premiere I've already got two clips that we're going to use for this demo. The first clip is a drone shot flying towards a lighthouse. And the second one is a clip of me and my cat opening a door inside my house. First we're going to need a sequence to work with, so we're going to right click on one of the clips and select New Sequence from Clip. This will create a new sequence based on the settings of the video clip. Next I will delete the audio track because we don't need it for this demo. And then move the clip to the second track of the timeline and scrub forward to the point where the door opens. I think this is the frame that we're looking for. Now I'm going to press the C key on my keyboard to enable the eraser tool and then cut the track at the point of the playhead. After that we can switch back to the selection tool by hitting the V key. Now I'm going to select the second part that we cut off and then move over to the effects control panel. And then inside the opacity section we're going to click on this pen tool or the free drawing bezier tool. And with this tool enabled we can create a mask over the door opening. This is a very precise work, so you'll probably want to zoom in to get a good look at the details. Now that we can see the point where the door opening starts, we can start left clicking to create a mask. Just take your time to add mask points and finish the mask shape. It will all look a lot better when the mask is perfectly aligned with the doorpost. And finally, you can finish the shape by left clicking on the first point. Okay, so now we've created a mask, but the outside of the mask is all black. And that is why we need to invert the mask here inside the effects control panel by clicking this checkbox. In the next frames, the door opening will get bigger, and that is why we need to enable keyframes for mask path by clicking on this stopwatch icon here. We can now skip a few frames forward by hitting the arrow keys on the keyboard and then change the shape of the mask. To do this, make sure you've got the mask selected in the effects control panel and zoom in again to make the adjustments. You can now simply left click on the mask points that you've made before and reposition them so the mask will fit inside the door opening. And again, take your time to align the mask exactly with the doorpost. It will look a lot better. You need to repeat this same step every couple of frames. I will fast forward this part because you've already seen how to do this. As you can see, I've now created the first set of keyframes. At these points, the mask is resized so it will match the shape of the door opening. I'm going to fast forward again and create a couple more keyframes. I think that this is enough for the sake of this tutorial. We could always add more keyframes if needed. Now it's time to add the drone clip to the timeline. We can put this one on the first track below the clip with the door opening. And as you can see, the drone shot is now visible through the mask. In the final step, we're going to give it a bit of a bloom effect. In the effects panel, I'm going to search for the dip to white effect. I'm going to apply this effect to the beginning of the drone shot and I will also extend the duration. And now if I scrub to the timeline, you can see this nice white glow at the beginning of the drone shot. And that's all for this quick door transition tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it and if you did, then please like the video, that really helps a lot. As always, thanks for watching and I hope you have a wonderful day.